Hey, good morning, church. My name is Spencer Osborne, and I'm the high school pastor at the Fallbrook campus, bringing you the Daily Dose today. So over the last couple of weeks in the high school group, we've been going through this series of the fruits of the Spirit. And the other day, we were discussing joy. And joy is a big one that we were discussing because it seems like we're kind of lacking that nowadays. I mean, all you have to do is spend a few minutes watching the news or on social media to see that it just feels like everybody has something to complain about. Everywhere you look, somebody is upset about something. And it seems like so many of us have been robbed of joy. That joy has been stolen from our lives in one way or another. And as we're discussing this, obviously throughout the New Testament, if anybody is a perfect embodiment of the fruits of the Spirit, it's Jesus. And so we were looking at examples in his life in the New Testament of how he not only has joy, but he's marked by joy, where it seems like that's one of the very defining characteristics of how he lives his life and interacts with people. And I think that's evidenced in the way that children in particular are drawn to him. We see a couple times in the New Testament where children just gather around him and people are drawn to him. And I think that's because he has joy, and he has this joy that's contagious, and he has this joy that's also constant. And it's interesting, we were actually studying, we were going through Hebrews, and in chapter 12, this is I love this pep talk right here. In verse 1 it starts, it says, "Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders us and the sin that so easily entangles, and let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us." And this is interesting. This is something that I hadn't caught before. In verse 2, it says, "Let us fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, who for the joy set before him endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God." So right here, that's the first time I've ever read that verse and seen joy being described as a motivator for Jesus. What he went through on the cross, being absolutely, literally excruciating pain, he was motivated by joy. And I believe that that's a joy that he wants us to be able to have in our own lives. And what's interesting is if you look at these different examples, the things that we place our joy in, the things that we place our identity in, those are the things in our lives that are going to be glorified. But the things of this world are all temporary. And so we can't be surprised when that joy is short-lived and when that joy ends up being temporary. When we're placing our joy, when we're placing our peace and our trust and our identity in these temporary things, whatever it might be, whether it's entertainment or sports teams or this and that, all those things are going to die away. All of those things are temporary, and so that joy is temporary, and then we go through that season of that joy being robbed from us. But God wants us to enjoy something that's eternal. God wants us to be placing joy in him because he is eternal and he is constant. And we know all these different attributes of God. He's all loving, all knowing, all powerful. But my favorite attribute of his is his immutability. He has the attribute of being immutable, which means he is unchanging. And because of that, we can have this certain confidence of if we place our joy in him, if we place our joy in something that is eternal and unchanging, then despite the circumstances, despite the different things, the different seasons that we go through in this life, we have that confidence to hold on to. Joy is so much more than just a feeling. Joy is so much more than just an emotional response, because emotions change, feelings change. But God doesn't, and he doesn't want you to miss out on that joy. Thank you, church. Look forward to seeing you again.